it does bring attention to sort of, you know, Michael Jordan's legacy and standing when it comes to specific issues surrounding race and injustice. And I also think that when he was playing, after he stopped playing, I think a lot of people wanted him to be more vocal because he was, you know, he had this platform and he was this god of basketball. And because he was, you know, one of the most marketed African-American sports athletes in the world, I think people wanted him to sort of like talk out on these issues. I guess my thought is that, yeah, it's not black and white. And perhaps he thought that by being the god of basketball, by being as good as he was, and by kind of like creating this, you know, multi-billion dollar company, that that was enough. That was enough in terms of like, you know, if I'm going to, you know, show and prove and put up, then I'm going to be the greatest basketball ever. And I'm going to create a multi-billion pound company that employs African-American people. And, you know, like that's my activism. I don't necessarily have to march. You know, I'm giving opportunities to African-American executives and I'm the greatest basketball player ever. That is, yeah, I guess that's my counterpoint. I think Michael Jordan was existing in a different time. You know, there wasn't a massive expectation from our athletes to sort of like be vocal on these issues as there is now. And I think that athletes now have the luxury of almost like looking at athletes like Michael Jordan and realizing that perhaps, okay, well, MJ didn't talk about that. And I think it's important to talk about this and like this, these athletes being conscious of their legacy, but also just talking up for things that they feel is right to talk up on. So, yeah, I don't know if that answers your question. I don't necessarily feel it's a straight and easy debate to navigate, but I think there are pros and cons to sort of, you know, both sides. So, yeah.